When it comes to great years for Celine Dion, it doesn't get much better than her remarkable 1997. It seems that not a week went by when I wasn't reporting that Celine had a number one recording or was being given a new award. And just when it seemed like she couldn't possibly top herself, she did, and everyone else as well. She won two Grammys, becoming an even bigger international superstar than before.
And the album of the year is Falling Into You, Celine Dion.
I can say that this year has been an amazing year for me. I can say that last year has been an amazing year for me. I can say that 5 years ago it's been, you know, all my life so far, it's been an amazing life.
Celine Dion's amazing life started in French-Canadian Charlemagne, Quebec. Born the youngest of 14 children to a working-class mother and father, Celine's family didn't have a lot of money, but they possessed a wealth of musical talent.
When my brothers and sisters put me on the kitchen table and they dressed me up, and it was just like, I was like giving my first performance. I knew that that was going to be my life. I love the attention of watching them looking at me and going like this with the encouragement and the applause and going like... I was asking my mom, Mom, you know, I want to be a singer. And poor mom, I mean, the 13 brothers and sisters, they kept saying the same thing all their lives. I want to sing, I want to be a singer, I want to be in show business, and blah, blah, blah. I guess I was the luckiest one in the family, being the last one. Because now, being the last one, she could give me her time.
Her mother decided if Celine was going to be a singer, she was going to do it the right way. After writing and producing her first song with Celine's older brothers and sisters, Mrs. Dion used the demo tape to get the attention of one of Canada's best-known talent managers, René Angélil.
Did the first album, it worked, and the second one, and the third, and I went to Europe, and the fairy tale started.
Celine's career exploded, quickly turning her into the largest selling artist in Canada, and then the world. As her career matured, so did her relationship with her longtime manager, René. Though 27 years her senior, she felt she no longer wanted to keep her feelings for him a secret.
I always loved him. We always loved each other. We always respected each other. But at one point, we're not 14, and here I am, 20, 21, understanding other things, discovering new things in life, and finding myself with a fairy tale, with a Prince Charming, and in love, and got married, and having the best time of my life with him. We're supposed to take this year off to try to have a little baby, and if it happens, we'll be incredibly happy. And if it doesn't happen, we are very happy. But I'll be the first one to tell the world that I'm pregnant. I am not. If I am, I'll scream it to the world.
Celine's amazing year culminated with the release of her new album, Let's Talk About Love. This CD contains some very special guests.
Tell him that the sun and moon rise in his eyes.
It is a dream come true for me to sing with Barbara. She's the person that I look up to the most in my career. You know, having been with her in her home, where she invited us for dinner, and she was so incredible, and she's so beautiful. Like, I was watching her, and at one point I cut myself being looking at her so much. Like I said, Celine, stop being a groupie. I consider myself a very, very lucky person. I think it's much too much for one human being to have everything like that. But I'm enjoying every moment of it.
It
It's fun to think of Celine as a groupie, isn't it?